Path to desirelessness. Desirelessness is the path that leads to the experience of totality. It leads to the experience of the immortal within. We have to understand the difference between categories of desires. According to economics, first there is need, then there is want, and then there is desire. There are certain basic needs, the food and shelter. Then in relation to your resources, you want them, then arises the demand. One can desire anything whether one wants it or not, whether it is relevant or not, but mind always finds logic to desire anything. Life and death are two poles of existence. Death is more total and significant than life. Life is just trivial and superficial. Death is far deeper. Through death, you grow into real life. And through life, you can only reach death. Life is a continuous journey. All that you understand by life is just a journey towards death. The entire life is a journey and nothing else. Once you know that life is a journey, you will be less interested in life. Your interest in death will increase. Once you are interested in death, you can delve deeper into life. You will not want to remain on the circumference. Death does not mean what we understand by death. When we continue to live on the circumference, on the outer life, where everything is changing every moment, we are not aware of this. The relationships, or whatsoever you call, goes on changing. But by nature, we cannot be interested in death. In every possible way, we want to escape death. We are afraid of death. What is the reason? We have made our life a garden while we have completely deserted the domain of death. And everyone is afraid of moving from an oasis to a desert. Death is not far. It is now and here. We are dying every moment. It is true. Psychologically, physiologically, and emotionally. There are trillions of cells. Every moment, the cells are undergoing change. The process of undergoing a change when something disappears into something new is the aspect of death. The cells in the body takes 3 months to rejuvenate. The old cells die, new are born. This is a continuous process. If these cells do not die and give birth to new, there will be stagnancy. We are dying every moment. It is true psychologically, physiologically, and emotionally. Every moment cells die in our body and in their place new cells are born. Human skin constantly changes. While we are dying, we continue to be concerned about life. Such concern about life is just a deep concern of fear. Death is right here. It is deep inside, and not only there, but it is growing constantly. What you need to do is take an 180-degree turn. When you are concerned with death, then life will unfold a new meaning to you. Indeed, life will unfold a new meaning to you. You are at ease with death. Without any fear, you enter into a deathless life, a life of tranquility and bliss. The moment you come to know death, you will encounter life eternal. Death is the door from the superfluous life and the so-called life, the trivial life, the life that lives on the circumference. When you pass through this door, you enter into another domain of life that you have never known, that you have never encountered. A dimensionless domain of eternity. A dimensionless domain of deeper, eternal, deathless life. From the life on the circumference, which is nothing but death, you pass through the door of death. Then you experience a life that is existential and eternal without death. To reach the domain of immortality, you have to pass through the door consciously. We die many times, but only unconsciously. We consider death as something inauspicious and ugly. We die most of the time in a state of sleep or while unconscious. We are so afraid of death that the moment death approaches us, we become afraid and unconscious. When you die in this state, you are reborn. The whole process repeats itself and thus continues the saga of journey of the being. But you are not concerned with death. Once you are ready to experience death rather than life, then you can pass through the door of death consciously. This is what meditation is. Meditation implies you pass through the door of death consciously. When emotions are changing, when the cells of the body are dying and new are born, when skin changes, you are not bothered about it. You are not even aware of it. But it is a constant change that takes place. Morning comes, gives way to mid-morning. Mid-morning gives way to noon. Constantly change is taking place. This is life and death continuing together. Meditation implies to pass through the door of death consciously. To die consciously is meditation. However, you cannot wait for death because death happens every moment. And the door is not somewhere outside. Also, it is not a normal door that you know. The door is inside you. It is right there now. What is necessary for this is to accept the very fact of death. Once you have accepted death, feel it every moment, live it and be aware. Then suddenly the door opens. And through this door, you begin to glimpse the life eternal. It is only through death you can experience eternity. It can be said that meditation is conscious death, a voluntary death. This is just a process of deepening within and drowning within. You are no more on the surface. Instead, you are moving deeper into your being. By death, this means moving away from the surface, from the circumference to the center. Death means withdrawing yourself from all that is superficial and returning to the source. In the night, you withdraw yourself from all activities, all relations and everything. You move into a solitary place where you rest. Death is that resting place. And when you come out of that sleep consciously, you are rejuvenated. How does this happen? When you grow in meditation or it deepens, you start moving away from the surface. Surface implies the world operated by senses, duality, and illusions. So when you start going deeper, you find darkness inside. Also, as soon as you leave the surface, you feel you are dying. You have identified yourself with the surface life for long. On the surface, there are waves, and waves are not ocean. Ocean is the totality, and waves arise on the surface of ocean because of gravitational force of the earth, that the air that remains there. So too, your surface life is accentuated by actions, illusions, and life force. Instead, you are losing your identity, your past, your mind, your memory. Up to now, all this was your reality. This you have to let go and transcend beyond the surface. Only then you can reach the reality. This reality is eternal, immutable. So when you are ready to die, this very readiness becomes the transcendence. This very readiness on your part is religiousness. When you say this surface, when you say this particular person is worldly, it means he is more concerned with life than death. A religious person dies every moment. He does not carry the emotions, the thoughts of now into the next moment. This means he is ever ready for the new and the